Babu, Kanna, listen here. From a point on the ground, the elevation, the angles of elevation of the bottom and top of a tower, fixed at the top of a 30 meter high building are 45 degree and 60 degree respectively. First, you should know how to read the problem and what are they have given to draw the diagram. Find the height of the tower from the point on the ground. So, this is the ground. So, from the point on the ground, the angle of elevation, of the bottom. So, this is bottom. Then, on the top. And the top of the tower. So, this is the tower. Understand? This is what? Tower. Fixed at the top of 30 meter high building. So, this is building. This is nothing but what? Building. What is the height of the building? 30 meter. Just from the question, you should be able to draw the diagram. From the point on the ground, the angle of elevation. So, you have to draw the line of sight like this. Because you are seeing the bottom. This is bottom. This is what? Bottom. This is what? Bottom. This is top. Isn't it? This is bottom. Bottom and the top of the tower. Fixed at the top of a 30 meter high building. So, this is building. Suppose if you want to, just for your understanding, I am coloring this. So, this red color is nothing but tower. Here, this green color is nothing but the 30 meter height building. Understand? First, for your understanding only, I am using the color, but in the exam, you should not use colors. Only one color you have to use. This is the tower and this is the building. Understand? What are the... So, fixed at the top of a 30 meter high building is 45 and 60. So, where you have to mark this 45 and 50? 45 is what? Bottom. 45 is what? Bottom. Because first what they have given? Bottom. Next one is top. So, while you are seeing the bottom, what is the angle? 45 degree. This is what? 45 degree. This is the bottom, isn't it? So, 45 degree. Next one is what? You are seeing the top of the tower. So, this is 60 degree. Understand? Do you follow all of you? So, like this, you can draw the diagram and you write the measurements and angles. All the measurements you have to mark it. Here, I told you, from this you are seeing, like this also you can write. Suppose if the point is here, then the angle of elevations will be like this. Isn't it? So, this is the tower. And this is the building. It should be straight. The line should be straight. Since I am using this electronic pen, I am unable. Understand? So, top of the tower. So, this is bottom of the tower. So, this is 45 degree. And this is 60 degree. This is 30 meter. Understand? So, the point is here. Understand? So, but in the book, they have given A, B, C, D and all. But it is very easy. If you understood the problem, then it will be very easy to draw the diagram like this. Understand? If you want to mention the color, you use pencil and your pen, blowing pen. Understand? So, like this also you can draw, like this also. There are two ways to draw the diagram. Just to understand that also. Understand? In the book, only one diagram they have given. So, like this also. But you have to mark the angle correctly because 45 is for bottom. Understand? Because respectively, this word, respectively. Then find the height of the tower. They are asking the height. So you mention this as height. Understand? So first, there are two thetas you will be framing. Isn't it? There are two thetas. First, you should frame 45. First, you have to frame 45 degree. Whether it is sine or cos or tan. This is opposite side. This is opposite side. This is 45. This is opposite. It is better to find out the adjacent. It is better to find out the adjacent because this is hypotenuse. This is a right angled triangle. This is a right angled triangle. Isn't it? So this is opposite and this is adjacent. Here this is opposite and this is adjacent. If you found out adjacent, then it is very easy to find out the hypotenuse if they are asking. So what theta you got to frame? Tan theta. Tan theta equal to opposite side by adjacent side. But actually it is not necessary for your understanding I am writing. Understand? So tan 45. First it is better to find out tan 45. And also while you are getting 45, always the measurements will be equal. Because I told you three angles you have to remember. 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree. 30 is what? 3 is here. So, for the remember, shortcut. Understand? 1 by root 3. Otherwise, fingers method you have to use. Understand? Like this. So, 30. 1 by root 3. This 1 is for 45. Like that you can remember. Then, this root 3 is for 60. So, tan 45 is nothing but 1. Tan 45 is what? Opposite by adjacent. Just you mention this adjacent with the help of the letter X. Distance. Understand? So, 30 by X. Tan 45 is 1. So, 30 by X. So, X is equal to 30. So, you got X is equal to 30. Next is what? Tan 60. Tan 60 is nothing but 30 plus H. This full side you have to, because 60 is the whole angle, isn't it? So opposite side is nothing but the full thing, full height. So 30 plus height. 30 plus H divided by adjacent, opposite by adjacent. Understand? So 30 degree. Tan 60 is nothing but what? Root 3. Isn't it? Do you follow? So, here what you have to write? 30 plus H divided by 30. So, cross multiply. Isn't it? This is nothing but 1. So, 30 into root 3 equal to 30 plus H. So, H equal to 30 root 3 minus 30. 30 is common. So, root 3. Here, what is remaining? Root 3. Minus 30 you have taken out. So, what will be here? 1. H. What is root 3? 1.732. So, 30. 1.732 minus 1 equal to H. So, this 1 will get cancelled. Suppose if you want to subtract like this, you do it. 1. 0, 0, 0. Understand? That means what? 0.732. So, 30 into 0.732 equal to H. You have to multiply this. You have to multiply this. Understand? 30 into. But you better to multiply with 3. So, 3 into 732. 3 2s are 6. 3 3s are 9. 3 7s are 21. Understand? That means H equal to 2196. What is it? Multiplying by 30. So, what you have to do? You add 0. After how many digits you have to keep the point? After 3 digits. So, what is the height? Height equal to 21.96. Whether it is given in meter or anything else. Meter only. So, you have to write meter. 21.96 meter. This is nothing but what? Height of the tower. If you are writing H, then you got to mention let h be the height of the tower. Like this you have to mention if you are giving the answer in h equal to 21.96. Otherwise you have to write height of the tower. Height of the tower equal to 21.96 meter. Like this you have to write. Otherwise h equal to, if you are mentioning like this. Do you follow every one of you? So you choose the diagram how you want to draw. Understand? Either this way or that way. While you are marking the angle, you should be very careful where you have to mark. And also you are taking the angle also, whether you have to take sine or tan or cos, whatever it is. But I told you why you have to take tan theta, opposite by adjacent. It's very easy to find out adjacent. Understand? Because they are asking this only, height only. So no need to go for the hypotenuse.